Operation Pedestal was the most heavily escorted convoy mounted by the British during the Second World War. It was run through to Malta in August 1942, as the island came close to collapse under a fearsome Axis air and sea blockade. With over a dozen merchant ships and a vast escort, Pedestal was to be the last chance for Britain to preserve its hold on Malta and possibly on the entire Mediterranean. By the summer of 1942, the British Empire's position in North Africa was precarious. Defeat against Erwin Rommel's Africa Corps at Gazala had seen the loss of Tobruk, and Allied forces had been forced back into Egypt. The Germans were halted at El Alamein at the start of July, but the overall picture still looked gloomy. One of the key problems with the British was the almost uninterrupted flow of Axis supplies arriving in North Africa from Italy. This was because the island fortress of Malta, which was in the best position to intercept Axis shipping, was itself under blockade by hundreds of German and Italian bombers and submarines. The island had gone months at a time without a single convoy getting through, and was suffering shortages of fuel, ammunition, and food. By the summer, these shortages raised the spectre of a German invasion, which if successful would turn the central Mediterranean into an effective Axis lake. Churchill and the War Cabinet agreed that this prospect was simply intolerable, and so something drastic would have to be done. That would prove to be Operation Pedestal. Pedestal was an operation with a simple directive: get a single, massive resupply convoy through to Malta, whatever the cost in ships. This would crucially include a large oil tanker, the Ohio, which would carry enough fuel to sustain Malta's civilian and military needs for 10 weeks. 13 other large, fast merchant ships were also quickly sourced from all over the UK and sent to Gibraltar, laden with supplies. Given the huge numbers of Axis aircraft, submarines and torpedo boats that Pedestal would face, it was given the largest and most powerful escort ever given to an Allied convoy. Surrounding the 14 merchant ships would be 2 battleships, 4 fleet aircraft carriers, 7 cruisers and 32 destroyers, in addition to assorted fleet oilers and 4 corvettes. 3 of the carriers would provide air cover to the convoy, while the 4th, HMS Furious, carried 36 Spitfires to be flown off to reinforce those already on Malta. It was a huge escort, commanded by Vice Admiral Edward Seyfried. On August 10th, the convoy passed Gibraltar and began its perilous journey into the Mediterranean. It did not take long for German reconnaissance aircraft to appear on the eastern horizon, but it was from the sea that the first blow was struck. Just after midday on August 11th, the German submarine U-73 managed to penetrate the screens and cross all 4 columns of merchant ships to hit and sink the carrier HMS Eagle with 4 torpedoes. It was a dreadful start, but there would be no turning back. By the evening, Pedestal was down to 2 carriers, as Furious finished flying off her Spitfires and headed west, taking 8 destroyers with her. It was then that the air attacks started. Initially, the convoy did well, shooting down 4 aircraft during a dusk attack on August 11th with no damage sustained. The next day, though, the attacks intensified. First, the merchant ship Deucalion was sunk during an attack by 70 bombers, followed by the destroyer HMS Foresight in a raid of over 100 Ju-87s and Italian Savoia 79s. 3 bombs hit the carrier Indomitable and crippled her flight deck, further depleting the British fighter cover trying desperately to keep the Axis bombers away. While this was happening, the convoy had begun to steam over a line of Italian submarines lying in wait. The Royal Navy destroyers went on the offensive, aggressively driving the subs away with depth charges. One, HMS Ethereal, actually rammed the submarine Cabalto, so desperate were the British to prevent torpedo attacks on the convoy. By this time, Seyfried's ships were north of Bizerte and approaching the Sicilian Straits. It was time for the heavy ships to turn back to Gibraltar, with air cover from Malta taking over from the single remaining operational carrier, HMS Victorious. 4 cruisers and 12 destroyers were to be left as escorts for the final leg into Malta, with Seyfried passing command of the convoy to Rear Admiral Harold Burrow. As the sea narrowed, flight times for Axis bombers reduced and the room to manoeuvre for the convoy vanished. As night fell on August 12th, the merchant ships were ordered to remodel themselves from 4 to 2 columns and the convoy was momentarily disordered. In the confusion, the Italian submarine Axum approached and torpedoed the cruisers Nigeria and Cairo, as well as the oil tanker Ohio. Cairo sunk and Nigeria had to turn back to Gibraltar, while Ohio was saved from succumbing to fire only by seawater rushing in through a gouge in her hull. It was to be the start of a torrid 3 days with the crew of the tanker. The largest significance of losing Nigeria and Cairo to the convoy was that they were the only ships to carry the radio sets needed to coordinate effectively with RAF fighters from Malta, which made Allied air cover much less efficient over the coming hours. At 8:30 PM, more bombers arrived, now striking virtually at will with a much less ferocious anti-air barrage greeting them. The merchant ships Empire Hope and Clan Ferguson were sunk, and the Brisbane Star damaged. 45 minutes later, the cruiser Kenya was torpedoed, but managed to continue limping along with the convoy. Just after midnight, German and Italian torpedo boats moved in, as the convoy fragmented more and more into a confusing melee. By the next morning, 5 more merchant ships had been sunk, with more damaged. Worst of all for the British was the state of the Ohio, which had taken more damage after 2 bombers had crashed onto her deck during the night. Both her and the Brisbane Star were badly damaged, and the list of invalids was soon joined by the Dorset, hit after more bombers arrived just before 11 AM. Barrow could not afford to wait for these ships and pressed on, with Spitfires from Malta and the odd destroyer doing their best to protect the stranded vessels. At 4 PM, with what remained of the convoy just a few miles from Malta, Rear Admiral Barrow detached, taking the 2 remaining cruisers and 5 destroyers with him back to Gibraltar. 2 hours later, the Port Chalmers, Melbourne Star and Rochester Castle limped into Valletta. The race was now on to try and rescue the 3 ships still at sea. Nobody knew where the Brisbane Star was, and the Dorset was sunk on the evening of August 12th, so efforts focused on the Ohio. The tanker looked for all the world like she would sink soon, but her captain refused to give up on his ship. Thankfully, 3 Royal Navy destroyers soon appeared, lashing themselves to each side of the ship and taking her under tow. The 4 ships crawled forwards at walking pace for the next 2 days, eventually reaching Valletta on the morning of August 15th. She was the last ship to arrive after Brisbane Star made it the day before, having gone on a wild detour that took her right up to the Vichy French Tunisian coast. The arrival of the Operation Pedestal convoy was massive for Malta. The 55,000 tons of supplies delivered rejuvenated the island's stockpiles, and the arrival of more fuel and Spitfires transformed the island's defensive picture. As the airspace over Malta became more secure, it became a safer base for British submarines and naval bombers, and Italian shipping soon began to suffer. In September and October, 27 Axis ships were sunk, including 2 tankers carrying fuel vital to Rommel's campaigns. Pedestal was a success, due in no small part to the courage of the sailors in the Merchant Navy. Captain Dudley Mason of the Ohio was awarded the George Cross, and Admiral Seyfret's report was glowing about the merchantmen. Both officers and men will desire to give first place to the conduct, courage, and determination of the masters, officers, and men of the merchant ships. This success came at a high cost, however. 9 of the 14 merchant ships had been sunk, along with an aircraft carrier, 2 cruisers and a destroyer, with a variety of other ships really quite badly damaged. This raises the question of whether the operation was worth it at a strategic level, to which there is no definitive answer. On the one hand, while it's true that Malta's salvation increased the attrition rate on Italian shipping to North Africa, Corelli Barnett argues that this had little impact on Rommel's supply situation. In Barnett's view, Rommel's main bottleneck was not supplies reaching North Africa, but the supply lines on land from the ports to his troops, which were badly overextended regardless of what happened at sea. On the other hand, Malta remained a painful thorn in the Axis side, not just immediately after Pedestal, but for the rest of the war in the Mediterranean, and saving it gave the Allies a perfect springboard for the invasion of Sicily in 1943. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. This video has been made possible by the kind support of my patrons. If you'd like to help me make more and better quality history videos, consider joining their ranks with the link in the description below. Thank you all very much for watching as always, and I will see you in the next video, where we'll discuss a different event in the Mediterranean war between Britain and France.